Hello and welcome back to our channel. Today we give you a piece of breaking news from People magazine. Prince Harry is too obsessed with Meghan Markle to find himself. Harry is not so smart. I say this because he was doing so well in the few years before he met Meghan. He turned his character around from an impish lout to a most respectable guy who, having, while his own issues, of course there were many, became a lovable character whom we began to take pride in. He won the nation's respect and admiration, and we felt he was caring and empathetic towards others and his various duties. Self-obsession was never the issue. The issues were flawed upbringing with an unreal setting of the UK monarchy, a contentious marriage between his parents, his mother dying in such a traumatic manner at such an early stage in his life, his whole life living under public scrutiny, his soul behind the brother who he could never be as equal to because William was the heir to the throne, his inability to pursue the career he loved, his inability to seek and keep the women he loved because most of them cleverly shied away from the life they knew they were going to have to endure with him. But outwardly taking all the above into account, he seemed to be biting the bullet and faring okay-ish. Of course, we now know differently. And so along came Meghan, and he seems to have completely unraveled. Some say he used her as an excuse to get rid of the royal family and flee to the US. Some say she's completely taken him over and is totally in control of everything. Personally, whatever the truth of the situation, I do not think it's anyone to blame or a question of self-obsession. I think it's what the seafaring people would call a perfect storm. Harry was fed up with his role, or lack of it, in the royal family, and he was becoming more and more the spare material. This he resented. Quietly festering was that chip on his shoulder against many of the aspects of his life he was not pleased with. His resentments were building and building against the media. Unrequited in his love life, the relationship between him and his brother was on the wane for some time pre the Meghan era. Then Meghan came along. Not only was he blindly in love, but she also dazzled him and was able to take control in a way he had not known previously. She clearly, right from the off, did not want to fit into royal life as she was supposed. Harry, by this time, was following her lead and was happy to follow her line. Right from the start, he has behaved inappropriately and landed himself in a great predicament. He has now lost so much respect from so many, preaching from his ivory tower in the middle of billionaire county, or whatever they call it. He's turned his back on his family and his public and the military personnel that held him so dear. Instead, he's decided to make little videos following his wife's woke dynamic. The trouble is, Harry is not Meghan. He's a prince by birth, and he's a duke still, with a lot riding on his reputation. Only today he's on TV in the newspapers after speaking online with a Black Lives Matter protester about his own, Harry's, racial biases. I do no longer follow Harry in that way and do not listen to Harry and Meghan's online diatribes, but I did catch this sentence which was broadcast on Sky News. Harry says, "Unconscious bias, from my understanding, having the upbringing and the education that I had no idea what it was and I had no idea it existed. As sad as it is to say, it took me many, many years to realize it, especially living a day or a week in my wife's shoes." In surfing the web for this A2A, I also found this sentence of his given in an interview to the Evening Standard last week to mark the start of Black History Month. "I wasn't aware of so many of the issues and so many of the problems within the UK and also globally. I thought I did, but I didn't." I found these two sentences really interesting, and also, I have to say, as a UK citizen, annoying. First, there's nothing annoying about bringing racism to the fore. Absolutely not. I'm 100% for that. What I think grates on me, and this question is about Harry and not Meghan, is that suddenly Harry seems to be awoken. Interestingly, in the first quote, he talks about walking in my wife's shoes. He certainly got that point right. He hasn't stopped walking in her shoes from the day they met. Poor Harry. He had no idea that racism existed or unconscious bias in the UK before he met Meghan. Really? All sounds disingenuous to me. Actually, we are all biased to certain degrees about many different aspects of life, and we should not call it unconscious, because if we are smart, we would call it what it is. But now we have Harry lecturing from afar online, we will soon find the error of our ways, I'm sure. I wonder what he was aware of then. I mean, having the upbringing and education he had, his words, and as he lives in the lap of luxury, taking private jets hither and thither, is he aware of people struggling to pay their mortgages, losing their livelihoods, not knowing where the next meal is coming from, not able to get access or afford the healthcare they need? Now scared to go on public transport and to work if they still have their jobs for fear of catching COVID. So, finally, in answer to this A2A, no, actually, I don't think Harry is self-obsessed. I think he's too obsessed with Meghan to find himself at the moment. That's about it. For a time, I had thought Harry was receiving some kind of mental help, and that could have been the explanation. During this period, the Cambridges and he started or supported the Headstrong organization. How sad it is that so many Brits think of Harry as a lovable rogue. That's the work of those palace vipers. They cleaned up his image so well after his racism was on full display. He was never lovable or even likable. He's still trying to become a real boy, just like Pinocchio. What do you think about the public profile of Prince Harry and Meghan Markle lately? I'm going to answer this question based on my perception of Harry and Meghan's public image. Not sure by what you mean by lately, as in time span. Going on the past 6 months, returned to California, this is how I see Harry and Meghan. Prior to leaving the UK for Canada, Harry and Meghan repeatedly stated that they wanted a private life to raise their son, Archie. They wanted a normal life, away from all the media, especially the paparazzi, to forge their own path in pursuit of becoming financially independent, to name a few reasons for stepping back from royal duties. March 31st, 2020 was the last official day they were classified as working senior royals, even though they had stepped back in November 2019, except for the March 7th, 2020 British Armed Forces tribute and March 9th, 2020 Commonwealth Day service. They arrived in Los Angeles just as the border was closing due to the COVID-19 pandemic. Since that time, Meghan has pushed herself and Harry into many public causes, done umpteen video calls, delivered a couple of food deliveries with a photographer in hand, put out an unsolicited speech to Meghan's old school in Los Angeles, Immaculate Heart High School, went to a local preschool to plant flowers, this was reported as a surprise to the staff, went to baby charity to give away, again uninvited, and they wanted the charity to pay for them to fly instead of them driving a 90-minute drive. Harry and Meghan hired the plane and photographer for a roughly 15-minute photo op. The list goes on and on. Meghan has pushed or bought her way into high-profile events, the virtual 2020 Girl Up Global Leadership Summit and International Women's Day, to name just a couple. Harry and Meghan have caused an uproar in many areas of public concern. Black Lives Matter, Harry showing his lack of knowledge about the Commonwealth countries, and race history within his country of birth. Harry canceling a fundraiser for the Invictus Games. Yes, I know COVID-19 played a part, but they could have done it virtually, like their many speeches. The biggest faux pas is politics. Harry still has foreign titles, and Meghan still uses as a means of leverage to her benefit. As royals, this is a major no-no. They are entitled to their opinions, just as everyone else is, but publicly they are to appear apolitical. Meghan can vote. Harry, no-no. All the items I've mentioned and those I have not are actions of someone seeking to be seen and heard, not that of someone seeking privacy. Harry and Meghan are constantly saying what they want in one breath, then in the next breath do the complete opposite. This gives the public image of you need to do this, but I'm privileged and don't have to. They have yet to become financially independent. They've taken so much charity from several people in the past months that it's unacceptable. They continue to get money from Harry's father, Prince Charles, which is shameful. Between the two of them, if they lived more privately or normal, as they state they want, there wouldn't be a need for Prince Charles to support them. This again tells me they refuse to live the life they preach about to the poor or even middle-class income people throughout the world. After all, Harry and Meghan have a very poor public image. I may be part of a small group of people who make up a small percentage of the world population, but I do believe that percentage is growing, and growing at a faster rate than their approval percentage. How about you? Do you think Prince Harry is too obsessed with Meghan Markle to find himself? Please let us know in the comment section below. Don't forget to like and share with your own followers. And as always, subscribe to our channel for all the latest news on the royal family, Meghan Markle, and Prince Harry right here. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.